yourself on a bolster, or if you have a pillow nearby. And then bring the hands to rest on the knees, palms either facing up or down. And just really allowing yourself to find a shape that feels good. So we really want to search for this shape of the body where we feel really light in space. So we aren't leaning too far forward or too far back. The spine is long, the sit bones are rooted and grounded. And then if you haven't already, allowing the eyes to feel closed. And simply first, just connecting to the breath. Inhale through the nose. Let go of anything that feels heavy out through the mouth. Once more like that, take a big breath in. Let go of whatever you need to. Big exhale out. And then reseal the lips. And then let this be the thread throughout your practice. So, in no attachment or expectation of the next asana, the next breath. And again, can you get out of your own way and just bravely let things unravel and unfold and flow? So from here, you're going to take a big inhale, bring your bend into the left elbow, peel the heart up towards the ceiling. And then as you exhale, draw a full circle in the fingers, so send the left fingers down outside of the left knee. Scoop it as far forward as you can, and then land with the bicep back in the air. So inhale, bring it back into the elbow, send your heart up. And then exhale, draw a full circle with the fingers. So just starting to follow your own breath, your own rhythm. Again, really just allowing this sense of flow, so kind of getting out of your own way, letting it move in and out of the body with ease. Two more rounds of breath. Still moving, taking one more inhale, and one more exhale, and then back with the bicep. We stay here, we pause in space, take a breath in, and an exhale out. Coming back up through center with inhale, send the right fingers up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, swiping left hand side, drop left hand down, start cracking the elbow, maybe the forearm meets the mat. Right bicep is in the ear, palm facing down. And on your next inhale, pull back on the right elbow, start to offer the heart up. And then as you circle with the fingers. Inhale to crack the elbows in the heart. And exhale to create a full circle. So again, just moving at a breath or a pace that feels good. And if you feel comfortable, so you can bring the eyes to close. Two more rounds of breath. Slow movement, taking a long inhale. And one more exhale. We land back in a shape. Take a breath in. Stay, be here. Exhale out. Inhale, you rise. Send the left fingers back up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, grounding the hands either side of the hips. So we sit up for Paschimottanasana. So extending both legs out in front of you, strong flex in both feet. This is really early on in the practice, so if you need to, please listen to and love your body and bring a bend to the knees. Whenever you're ready, bring hands to meet at heart center, using the breath inhale to create space, spine and body along. And then in no rush, exhale, enjoy the forward fold. So once you're in this shape, hands on the body or on the mat, somewhere that feels good. And then we use the breath, so as you inhale, create space between ribs and hips, maybe some perspective or some clarity. And then as you exhale, start to fold the body down, bow the body down, soften the knee. Two more rounds like that, inhale, we create space. And exhale, we fold into the space we've created for ourselves. One more round like that, breathing in. Bow the body down, exhale. Staying as you are in the fold, taking one breath in and one exhale out. On the next inhale, come to halfway, lift gaze as forward, and then exhale, soft walk of the hands back up towards the hips. So we meet in our first tabletop, crossing over ankles, hands in front of knees. Step the knees underneath the hips. This one, we're going to tap our 10 toes under. So making sure the fingers are spread nice and light on the mat. You're going to move through cat and cow, so if you're comfortable with your eyes are closed. As you inhale, send a tailbone up towards the ceiling, drop the belly, fill the belly and the body with the breath, lift the chin. And then as you exhale, in no rush, tuck the tailbone under, draw the belly in towards the spine, press the back of the heart up, pull the chin to the chest. Two more rounds, we inhale. Soften the belly down, pull the heart through. And big exhale, draw the belly to spine, empty the body of the breath. One more round, creating space, front line of the body, inhale. And then creating space, back line of the body, exhale. Coming to a neutral spot as you breathe in. Keeping the toes tucked, exhale, come back to sit on the heels, Japanese seat. We bring the hands to meet at heart center. As we inhale, sweep the arms out loud, palms face forward. And then as we exhale, equal arms, cross the right arm over, lift up, under, bring the palms back around to touch. As we inhale, draw the elbows up to shoulder height. And then exhale, send the hands away from the face. Start to drop the chin to the chest. And imagine breathing into the space between your shoulders. Stay as you are, fully present. One more inhale. And one more exhale. On your next inhale, lift the chin, keep the eagle arms, stack the hips up over the knees. And then try not to use your arms. As you exhale, slip the right foot forward, we come to a low lunge. So untuck the left toes, and as you inhale, send the fingers up towards the ceiling, start to offer the heart space up. Keep surrendering and melting into the still connected sound of the breath. As you are taking one more breath in, create space. And then exhale, half on one, release the hands to the mat, straighten the front leg, strong flex in the foot. So again, just allowing the breath to rest here. So always using the inhales to create space. And my exhales to deepen our perspective, deepen our presence, and deepen the hold. As you are taking one more inhale and one more exhale. On your next inhale, we're going to step to a wide chair. So plant the right foot down as lightly as you can. Step the left foot forward, feel your hip distance apart. Scoop the fingers down and up. Keep drawing the belly in towards the spine, lengthen the tailbone down towards the mat. Active right to the ends of the fingers. Active to the breath, so connected some of the breath. Staying as you are taking your breath in. See if you can sit the hips a little further down. Exhale out. As you are, one more breath in. Exhale, forward fold, palm the hands down to the mat, straighten the legs. Inhale, take halfway, left gaze is forward. On an exhale, setting up for Parahastasana, so slide the hands as much as you can underneath the feet. The toes are in the crease of the wrists. If you need to, you can bring a generous bend into the knees. And then on your next inhale, halfway lift, lead with the heart, try and lift the gaze, lift the chin. And then as you exhale, send the elbows out wide, keep pressing the toes into the hands, start to draw the crown of the head down to the mat. Check in, where is the breath? As you are, one more breath in, one more exhale. When you're ready, soft release of the hands to the mat, take halfway lift, inhale, gaze is forward. Exhale, we step back to high plank, one foot and then the other. Take an inhale here, bring the shoulders over the fingers. Exhale, drop knees, chest, chin, to core, biceps, touch the side body. Inhale to cobra, come halfway up, tops of the feet to the mat. And exhale, downward facing dog, sending the hips up. Exhale, come to cat through the belly to the spine, press out of the ground on the breath. Two more rounds, we inhale. Belly to spine, we exhale. One more round, breathing in. And belly to spine, breathe out. Inhale, come to a neutral spine, belly is engaged. Exhale, Japanese seat with all 10 toes tucked. Bring the hands to heart center. Inhale, sweep the arms out wide. Exhale, eagle the arms left over, right under, palms back, ground to touch. Inhale, draw the elbows up, shoulder height. And then exhale, send the hands away from the face, drop the chin to the chest. How could you send the breath into back body, back of the heart space? Stay as you are, one inhale. And one more exhale. On an inhale, lift the chin, stack the hips up over the knees, and then as you exhale, one arch, step the left foot away. Untap the right toes, and as you breathe in, send the fingers up towards the ceiling, start to send your heart space. Stay connected, sound the breath as you are, one more inhale. Exhale, heart from the mind, release the hands to the floor, straighten the neck, and flex. Again, still connecting some of the breath, even in the moments of stillness. Using this breath to keep you present in the body. As you are taking one more breath in, and stay, exhale out. Inhale to your wide chair, plant the left foot down, step the right foot forward, scoop the fingers down and up. And stay, settle the hips down, exhale. Breathing in. And breathing out. As you are, last inhale. Exhale, forward fold, hands to mat, straighten the legs. Halfway lift, we breathe in. Prep for Padahastasana, exhale out. If you need to, bend the knees, inhale, float the heart forward. And then exhale, send the elbows wide, start to reach the crown of the head down to the mat. Breathing in. Breathing out. Inhale. Exhale. Slightly release your hands to the mat, take halfway lift, inhale, gaze is forward. Exhale to step back, kind of neck. Stay here, take an inhale, shoulders over fingers. Exhale means chest, chin to floor. Inhale, cobra, come halfway up. Exhale, downward facing dog, send the hips up. Stay up here and down, now get a big breath in. And a big sigh. Whenever you're ready, on an inhale, bring the shoulders back, put the wrists in front of high plank. Exhale, drop the knees to the mat, tabletop, still keeping the toes tucked. As you inhale, float the right leg back, bring the right leg parallel to the mat, float the left arm forward. Belly is in towards the spine, find a gaze. So we stay here, take an inhale, this is the shape when the body is long. And then as you exhale, tiger crunch, draw the left elbow in towards the belly, draw the knee up towards the elbow. Inhale, we extend. And exhale to crunch. Three more, breathe in. And exhale out. Inhale, body long. And exhale, draw it in. One more round, we inhale, and draw in on exhale. Coming back to that extension as you breathe in. Keep the right leg up, place the left hand down onto the mat, exhale out. Inhale, three-legged down dog, float the left knee up over the right, start to guide the left heel down to the floor. Stay here as you exhale, stop to square the hips to the mat. So outer hip down, inhale flat out, digging points in the right foot. Keep pressing away from the top of your space, still witnessing the breath, taking one more inhale. On an exhale, pull the knee to the nose, bring the shoulders over the wrists. Pause in space, take a breath in. Exhale, pyramid pose, lightly step the right foot between the hands. Step the back foot in, heel to heel on that mat. So moving with the breath, halfway lift, inhale, gaze us forward, creating space. And then folding into space, exhale. You have three breaths as you arm your forward fold. So even in these moments of stillness, the gaze is still connected, sound of the breath. Stay for last breath in. And last exhale. On an inhale, take halfway lift, gaze is forward. Exhale, wide forward fold, pivot on both feet, walk the hands between your fingers. An option to stay in stillness, otherwise flow with the breath. Take halfway lift, inhale. And forward fold, exhale. Two more like that, take halfway lift, breathe in. And forward fold, exhale. Once more like that, halfway lift, inhale, creating space. And bow to the mat, exhale, forward fold. This time, here we want to come to halfway lift as you breathe in. And then walk the hands to the side of the right foot, spiraling both feet, exhale out. Inhale, come to standing split, send the left toes up towards the ceiling. It's really important again that the hips are squared down to the mat, so outer hip down, inner thigh up. Active right to the ends of the toes, and then bow the belly over the thigh. Soft rotation from the chest, scooching higher hip down to the mat. Still breathing as you are taking one more breath. Run away, exhale out. On an inhale, low lunge. Softly bring your step the left toes to the back of the mat, drop the back knee down, untuck toes, and scoop your fingers up towards the ceiling. As you exhale, press the palms to touch, bring it back into the arms, and tip the thumbs down to meet the spine. As you inhale, imagine creating space, front line above the body, so space between ribs and hips. And then as you exhale, start to encourage the elbows towards the back. Staying in the shape, breathing in. Staying and breathing out. On your next inhale, send the fingers back up towards the ceiling. Separate the hands, shoulder distance apart. And as you exhale, draw the left heel in towards the left glute. So if you're really struggling with this next transition, you're welcome to use the left toes to get there. Otherwise, draw the left heel in towards the body and then just using the knee and the core. Can you bring yourself up, single leg, mounting left foot to chest. On an exhale, finger four left and across the left knee. Bring the right hand or the hands to the heart center, left ankle across right knee. So evenly sitting both hips down towards the mat, you have an option to stay as your arch chest is lifted. If you'd like something more, start to bow the body over the left shin and bring the fingertips to touch the mat. So just moving the body around as much as you need to until you find really good sensations. And then and always asking yourself, where in the body do I need to seal the breath? Staying as you are, taking one inhale and one more exhale. If the fingertips are down on the mat, bring the hands back to the heart center. Warrior three, Virabhadrasana three, as you inhale, point the left leg back, left leg parallel to mat, draw the belly in towards the spine, square both hips down to the floor. So there's a strong flex in the left foot. Finding a point of gaze, drishti, and keep connecting back, ujjayi breath. As you are here, taking one more inhale. Exhale, bring a bend into the right leg, bring the left toes to hover just above the floor. We stay and pause, get present, breathe in. How mindfully can you land the left toes at the back of the mat? Exhale out. High lunge, inhale, send the fingers towards the ceiling. Stay, soften, serenity, and exhale. One more breath in. And then exhale, round the hands to the mat. Inhale, high plank, float the right foot back, keep the shoulders over the wrists. Exhale, bring the belly down to the floor. Inhale to Sphinx pose, tops of the feet to the mat. Set the forearms out in front of you, palms face down. Squeeze the shoulder blades as if you're going to slide the mat from underneath the body. Pull the heart up, maybe even lift the chin. As you are, taking one more breath in. And one more exhale out. On your next inhale, tuck the 10 toes under, forearm plank. So press out of the ground, draw the belly in towards the spine, fire up the quads. Rebring the body parallel to the mat. Staying, breathing, inhale. And exhale. Keeping the right forearm grounded, side plank on the right forearm, send the left fingers up towards the ceiling as you breathe in, rolling onto outer edges of both feet. So you have an option to stay here. If you'd like something more wild thing variation on the forearm, so send the left toes behind you, spiral the hips, the heart, the belly up to ceiling. As you are, last breath in. And then from wherever you are, exhale, sit the hips down towards the mat, press out in the right hand, come up to a seated position. So you sit up, join us yourself, noticing your left foot hold, left foot inside of the right thigh. Bring the hands to connect the heart center, inhale, through the right. And then exhale, we fold. So you have three rounds of breath in the shape. Allowing the breath to move and flow in and out of the body. You're coming up to a breath. On your next inhale, take half of your feet as forward. And then exhale, walk the hands back up towards the hips. Place the right hand down behind your fingers, face the front of the mat. Ground the left foot down to the knee. Inhale, full wildly. Press out of the ground and hips the heart the way up to ceiling. Keep sending the fingers down towards the mat, still breathing. As you are here, one more inhale. And then see if you can do this without the use of the left hand. Exhale, twisted lunge. Step the left foot forward inside of the right arm. Stay, take a breath and press out of the ground, lengthen up. Stay, keep drawing knees in towards midline and exhale out. On your next inhale, side plank. Step the left foot back, but this time you're going to step it in front of your right foot. So take an inhale as you are. Exhale, bring the bicep of the ear to the palm to face the floor, bend into both knees. Start to send the heart up, move around until you feel really good sensations in the body. Stay and take a long inhale, and one more exhale. Coming back to that side plank, breathe in. Grounding both hands down to mat, exhale out. Keeping the feet as they are, take an inhale. And then exhale, bend both knees, make it feel like a downward facing dog. Sending the hips over to the right hand side. Trying to ground both feet down and then intense breath into the lips up. Standing, breathing in. Breathing out. Come to high plank, inhale, roll onto the toes of both feet. Exhale, chaturanga if you need to use the knees. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. And exhale, we meet back in and down the crescent dog. Stay in down dog, take a good breath in. On an exhale, dolphin, drop both forearms down towards the mat. So you have a few options. You're welcome to stay in this dolphin shape.
If you want something more, right leg rises on an inhale, similar toes to the ceiling. And if you'd like to come up to a full pinch and take a breath in, send the hips up over the shoulders, draw the legs together, and we hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, half stop, you can do that. And then come to embryo, drop the knees to the mat, a beautiful release. Arms around the outside of the body, palms face up, drop the forehead to the floor. So just a time to reset, to check in with any dominant force around the feelings. Maybe a couple of big breaths in and out. And then on the next inhale, come to child's pose, sweep the fingers forward. And on your next exhale, downward facing dog, tuck the toes, flip the knees, and guide the heels back. Stay as you are in down dog, take a big breath in, and a big sigh out. Inhale, come to high plank, bring the shoulders over the wrists. Exhale, drop the knees to the mat, keep the toes tucked. On an inhale, flip the left leg back, bring the left leg parallel to the mat, and flip the right arm forward. On an exhale, tiger crunch, bring the knee in towards elbow, elbow towards knee. Inhale, we extend. And exhale, draw in. Inhale. And exhale. Two more, breathing in. And breathing out. Once more, body is locked, inhale. Draw it in, exhale. Coming back to that extension as you breathe in, only grounding the right hand down, exhale out. Three-legged down dog, inhale, left leg rises. Stay here as you exhale, notice sensations as you spread the hips to the mat. So really have this acute awareness of body and space. We're fully aware of the difference between the legs high as you can and the difference between the hips sway. Stay as you are, take a breath. Exhale, draw the knees to the nose, shoulders over wrists. Pause in space, get present. Inhale. Pyramid pose. Exhale. So step the right foot in. Ground the hands down. If you'd like to, halfway lift. Inhale first. And then exhale, soften the arm forward. So you have three rounds of breath in this pause. Maybe just getting present. Notice the breath. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders. Take halfway lift. Inhale, gazes forward. And then exhale, wide forward fold. Walk the hands on the right hand side. Pivot on both feet if you need to, wiggle up. An option to stay in stillness in your forward fold. Otherwise, moving with the breath. Halfway lift. Inhale. And then bow to the mat. Forward fold. And exhale. Lead with the heart, halfway lift, breathe in. Soften, fold, exhale. Once more, halfway lift, breathe in here. And forward fold, we exhale. Coming back to this halfway lift as you breathe in. On an exhale, walk the hands to the side of left foot, spiral on both feet. Standing splits, inhale, send the right toes up towards the ceiling. Upper body is soft, really anchored. And rooted in the left foot, and anchored and rooted in the breath. Staying, last breath in. Staying, exhale out. Low lunge, inhale. Really mindfully sit the right toes to the back of the mat, drop the right knee down, untuck the toes, scoop the fingers up towards the ceiling. And then as you exhale, press the palms to touch, bring a bit into the arms, send the thumbs to the spine. Inhale, we create space in the body. And then exhale, encourage the elbows back over. Breathe in. As you are, one more breath in. And one more exhale out. Inhale, send the fingers back up towards the ceiling. Separate the hands, shoulder distance. And then as you exhale, draw the right heel in towards the right glute. Option to use the right toes if you need to, otherwise just using the core. single leg mountain, draw the right knee towards the chest, inhale. Figure four, right ankle across the leg, knee hands to heart, exhale. An option to stay, please listen to your body. If you'd like something more, we're gonna fold forward, send the belly over the right shin and ground the fingertips down to the mat. So make sure you keep sending hips equally down to floor, right foot is still fixed. And again, where in the body do I need to send the breath? As you are, one more inhale, one more exhale. If the fingertips are down, bring the hands back to the heart. Virabhadrasana 3, inhale, foot the right leg parallel to mat. Bring hands to heart center, stay here and exhale. Find the breath, find the gaze, breathe in. Breathe out. One more inhale. Exhale, bring the bend into the left leg, hover the right toes above the mat, we stay, take a breath in. With intention, step the right toes back, exhale out. High lunge, inhale, send fingers to ceiling. Stay here, exhale. One more breath in. Ground the hands to the mat, exhale out. High plank, inhale, step the left foot back. And exhale, belly to the floor. Sphinx pose, press the forearms out in front of you, palms face down, tops of the feet to the mat. Inhale, squeeze the shoulders, pull the heart through. And stay, we exhale. Tuck all 10 toes under, inhale, forearm plank, press out of the ground, draw the belly to the spine. And stay, breathe out. Side plank on the left, forearm, inhale, roll onto inner and outer blade of the feet. Send the right fingers up towards the ceiling, stay here and exhale. You have an option to stay here, otherwise rolling on the forearm, step the right toes behind you, pick up the hips, the belly, the heart, and breathe. One more breath in. Good, and then exhale, set the hips down to the mat, press out of the left hand, and come up to the seated position. Down to the tops on the right, inside the left thigh, we move through the breath. Inhale, arms out. And exhale, before you fold. We have three rounds of breath doing this.
Stay, taking one more breath in.
more exhale out. Inhale to send the fingers forward, come to child's pose. And then exhale, slap the hands back, downward facing dog. Send the heels forward. On your next inhale, come back to high plank, shoulders over wrists. Exhale, drop the belly to the floor. So once you're there on top of the toes, you're gonna bring the right arm out in front of you. Cross the left arm in front of the right. And then use the fingers to wiggle the hands as far away from one another as you can. Maybe even flip the palms to face up. We take an inhale first. And then exhale, make the upper body as heavy as you can. See if you can bring your chin right in front of the left arm. And just witnessing this intense stretch into both shoulders. Keep listening to sound of the breath. As you are, one more breath in, one more exhale out. Pressing down into both forearms, really gently wiggle the arms into mid-center. And then you're going to change sides. So left arm out in front of you, right arm crosses in front of the left. Wiggle the fingers as far away from one another as you can. Flip the palms to face up, take an inhale. And then get as heavy as you can over both arms, exhale. One more breath in, one more exhale out. Pressing out of the ground as you inhale, walk the arms back through center, and then exhale, grounding hands underneath the shoulders. As you breathe in, create space between you and the earth, and then exhale, thread the right arm under the left, and come to that on our backs. So final posture or asana each side. So bring the arms out into a T shape, palms face up towards the ceiling, bring the knees in towards the chest. Take eagle wrap in the legs, right leg over, left leg under. If you can, toes back around the shin. Take an inhale first. And then exhale, drop both knees over to the left, take the chin or the gaze over to the right. If you feel safe to do so, bring the eyes to close.
Bring the lips to seal. And again, want you to imagine it as your inner well or your inner cup. And if you visualize it without judgment, is it full or is it empty? And then with the mind's eye, we're going to fill this inner cup with the breath. So you're going to inhale, fill up one third of the way. Space of renewal, of rebirth. And then when you're ready, pressing the left hand down into the mat, joining me in a seated position.